I want to focus more deeply on selectors. To do this, I've created a simple, unstyled web page. This web page showcases my top three favorite books of all time. If you couldn't tell, I'm a big survival and adventure fan. Let's try to add some styling to this web page. I've opened the HTML file, and using tag selectors, we could write some CSS that selects all the H1 tags, H2 tags, or paragraph tags. But what if we wanted to add style to the book summaries, but not the site description at the top? Using tag selectors, we can only select all paragraph tags. So what do we do? Thankfully, we have a few more ways to select HTML elements with CSS besides using tags. Instead, we can use attributes. I'm going to change my HTML file to demonstrate how this works. All right, so now I've reloaded my new HTML file with a few changes. If we look at the file, I've added this ID attribute, site description, to my first paragraph. And if we look at the rest of the paragraphs, I have this class book summary. These two attributes are extremely helpful. First, because attributes help us describe the content of the page inside the HTML markup. You can now clearly see that the first paragraph on my web page is my site description. Now keep in mind, ID should be used sparingly. That's because an HTML element can only have one ID, and IDs can only be used once per page. For example, if I type another ID, this is not okay, because I'm passing two IDs, site description, and another ID, to the same element. If I add the ID site description here, this is also not okay, because now I'm using site description in two places. If I wanted to add an ID here, I'd need to give it another name that has not already been used. If I change the ID to first book, then that would be okay. Generally, when you're styling your page, you'll be styling collections of elements, not individual elements. If you want to add the same attribute to multiple HTML elements, use classes instead, like I've done here for book summaries. Classes can be added to multiple HTML elements, and HTML elements can have multiple classes. This makes classes extremely powerful and flexible. You will use them constantly as a web developer, and most web developers prefer classes over IDs. Besides organization, these attributes can be used as CSS selectors. If I revisit my question from before, I wanted to style my book summaries differently than my site description here at the top. Using the ID and class selectors, I can easily do that. For book summaries, they use the class attribute, and in order to select an HTML element with a class attribute, I'll type a period followed by the name of the class. For the site description, it uses an ID attribute. In order to select an HTML element with an ID attribute, I'll type a pound sign or hashtag followed by the name of the ID. Okay, good. Finally, I'll add some quick styling to make sure our selectors work. Let's change the property color to blue for our book summary. And let's change the property color to red for our site description. Okay, now I'll save and refresh, and perfect. We can see that the site description and the book summaries are different colors, so our selectors worked.